Hey everyone, welcome back. मैं हूँ ज्योति.
और मैं हूँ श्रुति।
Yes. And today we are revisiting a song that we have heard before together.
Oh, अच्छा, why are we revisiting?
Because what you and I watched was a cover, an acoustic cover of this song. It was Yashal Shahid. Remember, she did this song called Sajna.
Yes,
and we loved
बहुत
it.
comments आए थे उसके बाद.
Yeah, बहुत
yes.
comments आए थे, and all the comments said that if you like this, you should listen to the original, which was on Nescafe Basement. And the writer of the song, Siftan Khalid, also performed it there. So, but
How lovely.
let's do it. Let's get to it.
So cool. Yes,
yeah.
Let's do this.
So
Very
it's
nice.
An original. It's from the season 3 of Nescafe Basement. I missed it completely. Achha. Written and composed by Siftan Khalid. Music produced by Zulfi. As always.
Lovely.
So,
let's
you know?
Do this.
Yeah, let's do it. 1, 2, 3, play.
Nescafe Basement, Season 3. तेरे धोखे ने सजना मैनू मार मुकाया मैं मरते गई आ फिर सा क्यों आया जग नू रवाया मैं तेनू हसाया फिर भी पल्ले मरते गईया फिर सा क्यों आया जग नू रवाया मैं तेनू हसाया फिर भी पल्ले
So
Oh, what an ending.
Wow. Wow. How they use the violin to extend the... oh my God, that was so beautiful. The instruments were used through and through the song so stunningly. You know, what's really surprising is, Jojo, if you wouldn't have told me that that song was the cover of this, because I somehow wouldn't have got it. You know, I somewhere in the middle, I would have been like, "Haan, ye lyrics sore sune sune hai," because the way it's been sung, it is so different in both the tracks that the feel of this is entirely different. No, don't you feel that? Or is it just me?
Like, no, that was completely like, you know, stripped of any instrumentation. It was mainly just her voice there with, I think there was just keys or some, or like one instrument in the background. Here it's like a
and
full...
the male female voice thing also makes such a huge difference.
It does.
Sounds fully different, like
So I mean, we know that Zulfi is a master arranger. The thing is, when he arranges the music of a song, and I've said this maybe before in other Nescafe basement reactions, it just takes you on such an emotional journey from start to end, because he knows which are those key points where an instrument will do more in terms of hitting an emotional chord than the voice.
Correct.
It's just mind-blowing. You know exactly when the acoustic guitar is hitting the right notes here, and when the violin is doing it perfectly, and when the flute is playing its role perfectly. It's all just...
On a very off note, I must like compliment the guitarist and the violinist on their hair. Because the moment it started, unke shiny baal yahan tha, I was like, dude, they've got really nice hair.
They're the Leo brothers.
Leo brothers, I know. Yeah. And I just looked at them and I was like, dude, baal.
What is the secret of your hair? But I'm seeing the credits. Electric guitar was Sherry Khattak. And he sang that other song that we reacted to. And then I was sent an email or a long message about all the things this man has done. Another very accomplished, brilliant musician. So he's there. Bass is Usman Sheikh. There's the flute, Nazar Abbas. Tabla, Shairi, Bakshi. And violin, Sharun Leo. Acoustic guitar, Harun Leo. Keyboards, Arslan Hassan. Drums, Bilawal, Lahuti. And backing vocals, Amna Imtiaz and Sibra Sharmi. Very nice. What a beautiful arrangement. Now let's talk about Sipte and Khalid, and he's written the song, which, like we said, even in the Yashal reaction, what beautiful lines, you know? Just beautiful poetry and
that bit now, his singing. Marta gaya sa kyun nahi aaya? Oof! Every time he sang it, you know, the feeling just kept going deeper. The meaning of that, which you absorb from the feeling. Wow! What a line! Oof.
And you know, there's something very nice about a man singing in the as a woman.
I don't know
why, but it hits differently.
So, you know, long back, you know, when I used to be a RJ, that time I remember when Teri Diwani, Kailash Kher, when that had come out, I remember having this chat with him. So I had asked him, saying, why the female, like, you know, why did you choose such a song where you were singing in the female? He said, very interestingly, he said, in Sufism and in everything, if you look at it, we, the Atma, is a female, and we are longing for the Paramatma, which is the male. So every female song, so technically, because all souls are female, so when you're singing a very divine song, it is always the female singing to the male.
That
because it has
so
nothing to do with the, it is not about the male and the female, but it is on the energy equivalent
on
of
the energy.
Shakti to the Shiv, or the, you know, Atma to the Paramatma.
Oh.
So it was so wonderful. So from now, since then, every time I listen to any male singer singing a female song, the entire perspective of the song changes for me. It suddenly goes to the divine level.
I think now it'll happen to me also. Yeah, that's a very nice way to explain it. I didn't know. Even I know Rabbi's Tere Bin, when that released, I just loved that he was singing from the female perspective. There's just something about songs that are written in that way. But very interesting take, I must say. Loved it. So I think the original ki baat hi kuch aur hai. That's all I'll say. I love Yashal's voice. Yeah, and she covered it beautifully in her own way. But this was just such a masterpiece, the song. Lyrically, musically, everything. Loved it. So thank you for recommending. Thank you for requesting. And other requests are welcome on Instagram. And Miss Bola's podcast YouTube channel is linked below.
So definitely go there and, you know, subscribe to the channel, subscribe to this one as well, and hit like. If you're liking a song, express it to us. We like it.
Yeah. Oh. Okay.
Yes.
See you soon. Bye.